Hey, Daud here. Today I am sharing with you a video from my self-paced PMP course. This video is about how to create scheduled dependencies. In other words, how do you link various activities to create a network diagram? So please let me know in the comments what you think about it. And here is the video.
There are four different ways a dependency can be created between two activities. When a dependency is created, one activity becomes the predecessor activity and the other activity becomes the successor activity. The successor activity depends on the predecessor activity. Or we can say that first work on predecessor activity, then work on the successor activity. The most common relationship is finish to start. When the predecessor activity finishes, then successor activity starts. So in the example, when activity A is done, then activity B starts. If activity A is late, the start of activity B will be late because it cannot start until A is done. This relationship is so common that it is not even identified on the schedule. And in the absence of any other relationship, it is assumed that this is the relationship. Here is an example. Two activities, assemble the saw and cut the planks. Finish assemble the saw, then start cut the planks. This is a finish to start relationship. Another type is the start to start relationship. Start the predecessor activity and then start the successor activity. If the predecessor is late, the successor activity will also be late. So start activity A, then start activity B. If the start of A is late, the B cannot start. It will also be late. Say one activity is write user manual and another activity is edit user manual. The project manager wants to start editing as early as possible. So puts down the relationship as start write user manual activity, then start the edit user manual activity. The third type is the finish to finish relationship. Finish predecessor activity, then finish the successor activity. Successor activity cannot be logically completed until the predecessor is complete. So finish A, then finish B. If the finish of A is late, the B will continue and cannot be logically completed. Now an example. Two activities. Internal cleanup and external cleanup. The project manager puts dependency as finish internal cleanup, then finish external cleanup. External cleanup can be done in parallel or before or after. If done before or parallel, it will not be considered complete as long as internal cleanup is incomplete. Maybe there will be no work under external cleanup after internal cleanup is done. But it is possible that while the building is internally cleaned, some stuff may end up externally, which will be needed to be cleaned. So this relationship will cover for that. The fourth type is rarely used. It is really for academic purposes that we are going to discuss. It is called the start to finish relationship. The predecessor activity cannot finish until the successor activity has started. So A cannot finish until B starts. It can be a little confusing to understand. Look at it in a different way. Execution wise, A is happening first and then B will happen afterwards. So we are calling A as predecessor and B as successor. Logically, in terms of relationship, it looks like B is the predecessor and A is the successor because A depends on B. Here is an example to explain this relationship. A security guard finishes the shift, which is called shift A, at 5 p.m. And the other security guard starts the next shift B at the same time at 5 p.m. There cannot be a gap between the two. What will happen if the second security guard is late and did not arrive on time? Shift A will continue and will only finish when shift B has started. So remember, there are four types of dependencies. Finish to start to start, finish to finish, and start to finish.